Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in this video I'm going to talk about a drug called barbiturates. All these points will be discussed, that is introduction to what barbiturates is, its action, absorption and metabolism of barbiturate, sign and symptoms, treatment, post-mortem findings and medico-legal aspects. So let's discuss them one by one. So introduction, barbiturates are drugs that are used as sedatives or hypnotics. They can help induce the sleep or they can help in betterment of the quality of sleep. So barbiturates have sleep related functions. They can also be used as anticonvulsants, that is a medication that is used to prevent seizures or to control seizures. It can also be used as anesthetic and as tranquilizer. These are drugs that helps in treatment of anxiety, fear, tension, etc. So barbiturates are drugs that can be used for a number of purposes. It can act as sedative, hypnotic, anticonvulsant, anesthetic and tranquilizers. So some of the common barbiturates that are used include secobarbital, pentobarbital and amobarbital. So these are commonly abused barbiturates. In recent years, barbiturates have been actively replaced by the benzodiazepines. So, their use has decreased markedly because of benzodiazepines. They have replaced the barbiturates for majority of clinical indications. Now, if we talk about the physical properties of barbiturates, how they look. So barbiturates are white in color, they are crystalline in nature, they do not have any odor, that is they are odorless and they have a bitter taste. The synonyms that are used for barbiturates include, they are also called sleeping pills, goofballs, yellow jacket, red devil, bluebirds, downers. So these are all the terms that are used for barbiturates only. Now let's move on to the action of barbiturates, how they work. So barbiturates increase the activity of a chemical in the brain that helps to transmit signals, and that chemical is known as gamma aminobutyric acid. So barbiturates are going to act on this chemical called GABA, that is gamma aminobutyric acid. So what happens is, if you look at this figure, the barbiturates are going to attach themselves to GABA, which is going to lead to activation of the GABA receptor, right? So if you look here, this is a GABA receptor and it has a barbiturate site on it. So a barbiturate comes and it goes and it attaches itself on the barbiturate site. Next, what happens is, this leads to activation of the GABA receptor, which further leads to opening of the chloride channel, due to which large amount of chloride, as you can see here, goes inside the cell. So this increases the duration of GABA gated channel, due to which more and more chloride is coming inside and the hyperpolarization of the cells occur, which is leading to depression of the central nervous system. So this is how they work. At very high concentrations, it can directly increase the chloride conductance Cl- and inhibit the calcium dependent release of neurotransmitters. It also depresses the sodium and potassium channel. Now if we talk about the absorption and metabolism, then if the barbiturates are taken orally, that is through mouth or through rectum, the absorption is usually rapid and complete. Now the rate of absorption increases even more if the barbiturate is taken in a liquid form. Also, the rate of absorption increases if the stomach is empty. Also, the rate of absorption increases if alcohol is taken along with the barbiturates. after IV administration, that is the intravenous administration, if the barbiturates are taken intravenously, then the onset of action is going to be immediate for barbiturates like amobarbital and pentobarbital, and it's going to take slight time, like 5 minutes, for the barbiturate phenobarbital. Once absorbed, the barbiturates are rapidly distributed to all the tissues and fluids. High concentration can be seen in brain, liver, and kidneys. Barbiturates are slowly metabolized in the liver, and these metabolites are mostly inactive, water soluble, and excreted in the urine. Only small amount of barbiturates are excreted unchanged by the kidney. So this was all about the absorption and metabolism of barbiturates in the body. Now here are a few signs and symptoms that can be seen after a person has taken a barbiturate of any form. If you talk about the central nervous system, then the sign and symptom include drowsiness, mumbling of speech, clumsy movement, trembling, unsteady gait, nystagmus, disorientation, delirium, hallucination, stupor, etc. If you talk about the respiratory sign and symptoms, then they are going to include rapid and shallow or slow labored breathing with reduced minute volume. Respiration may be irregular. Sometimes shine strokes can also be seen. Next, if we talk about the cardiovascular sign and symptoms, then we can get to see hypotension, cyanosis, bradycardia, fall in cardiac output, cold, clammy skin. The muscles can be flaccid, tonicity of the muscle is lost. Urine can be scanty or suppressed, dark in color, and may contain sugar, albumin, hematoporphyrin, and incontinence may occur. The skin might have blisters, also called barbiturate blisters. Blisters contain serous fluid, and on rupture they leave a red, raw surface which dries to a brown parchment-like area. And some other symptoms can include hypothermia, fever, etc. So this was all about this video. In the next video, I'm going to discuss about the treatment, post-mortem findings, and medico-legal aspects. So do watch that video also. Thank you for watching.